Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist here at American RV in gorgeous Grand Rapids, Michigan. Today I'm here to tell you all about the 2017 Sprinter Campfire Edition 29FK. This is a great front kitchen model, beautiful layout. Let's go ahead and start up front here, we'll make our way back, and then we'll head on in. So one of the first things you'll notice, this right here, which is your power tongue jack. This makes it a breeze to hook up and disconnect your tow vehicle. Just flip of a switch and it will raise and lower the front end. Also, you have a light on here, so if you need to hook up or disconnect at night, you can go ahead and utilize that. Behind the power tongue jack is the propane tank cover. Very easy to access the tanks. You have these two thumb screws, undo those, lift up the door, and then right inside you will see your two 30-pound tanks. Behind that, you can see the tray for your battery. Then coming up the front here is diamond plating. So that way, this will help protect your front end from any rocks or debris that get thrown up by the tow vehicle. Also, if you notice right up front there, something that's really cool and unique, you can see the large window. Of course, that is in the kitchen. We'll see that more when we go inside. Come back a little bit further here. If you are one that likes to watch TV when you're outside, that's not a problem. You have a cable hookup right here, electrical outlet there as well. What I would personally do is probably set up a table right here, put the TV on it, run your cords over. That way you're underneath the power awning. Large power awning on this coach, one touch of a button, it rolls out. Same thing to put it back in. And if you notice, in the heads of the power awning, there are speakers. That's pretty neat. That way when the power awning is fully extended, the speakers will play down on your campsite rather than blasting out at your neighbor. Also underneath the power awning is an LED light strip, so you don't have to get up there to hang up your Christmas lights. You can just flip the switch and have lights at night. Getting into the 29FK is very simple. You'll see you have three aluminum steps. I like the aluminum steps as well. Less chance for any kind of rust or corrosion on there. And you'll see they also have rubber strips. That way you can get some grip in case it does rain or dew in the morning. You won't slip and hurt yourself. Easy grab handle as well. Same thing, helps you get that extra grip you need in order to climb into the coach. So we move back a little bit further here, you'll see the nice alloy wheels. Again, less chance for rust or corrosion on those, and they sure do look nice. And then on either side, you probably can't see it here, but there is a little yellow plate. That's because this unit is equipped with the correct track alignment system. It's been proven over time that your axles will actually become misaligned. So what the correct track alignment system does is when you bring it in, we can easily adjust those plates to get your axles lined back up. That way you don't have to cut and re-weld them. Really definitely saves money on the maintenance side of things. Coming back a little bit further here, this one does have a couple different storage options. Of course, you don't have a front pass-throughs, it's a front kitchen. So one is right here, you will notice magnetic latch to hold it up. A little bit smaller one right here, but it is on the door side. So for items you get into often, like marshmallow pokers, things like that, it's a perfect spot for it right there. Coming around to the back side, you have the spare tire here that is mounted on the bumper. Of course, it comes with the cover as well to protect it from the elements. Satellite and cable inlets right there to go into the coach. Power stabilizer jacks on here. This is really cool. You know, it definitely makes, again, setting up easier. You have power tongue jack, power awning, power stabilizer jacks, trying to make you do as little work as possible. What's even cooler is this unit has the Camp Easy package, which comes with a little remote. With that remote, you can operate your jacks, your awning, your slides, the light on your awning, all from that remote. So that way you can stand out here, open up your slides, make sure you're not going to hit anything. Same thing with your awning. This one does have a detachable 50 amp power cord. It has a 50 amp over a 30 because this one is prepped for a second AC. It comes with one, but if you do want a second, it can be installed. And then right here on the off door side in the slide, again, magnetic latches, that lifts right up. Take a look at that. That is a huge storage area there. That goes underneath the bed. Of course, you can lift that bed up to access it from both points. Lift this guy up right there is a spray port. So if you need an outside shower, you have that. And then last thing, this right here is a black tank flush. This is cool too. If you're not familiar with the black tank flush, what that does for you, is instead of having to take a hose, drag it through your whole RV and shove it down the toilet to wash out your black tank when you're done camping, the black tank flush, just take that same hose, hook it right up here. That black tank has sprayers built in. It will go ahead and wash it out for you. But all right, that'll finish it up for out here. Let's go take a look inside. Welcome to the inside of the 2017 Sprinter Campfire Edition 29FK. As I said, this is a front kitchen floor plan. It's gorgeous. Let's start off right over here. This is a swivel rocker, of course, gives you a great place to sit, and you can go ahead and swivel it to watch the TV. You get a great angle. We'll show the TV in just a little bit. Then as we move into the kitchen, you'll notice here is your 7 cubic foot fridge freezer combo. Has the stainless front on there. You can see all the shelves, plenty of space. You have a crisper drawer down below too. This does run off propane and electric, and also has automatic switchover. Then as we move further into the kitchen, again, sticking with the stainless steel appliances, you have a stainless microwave right up here, fully functional hood with a light and a fan, and then your Atwood 3-burner cooktop with an oven. Underneath the oven, you can see here, great space, is a nice deep drawer, great spot for pots and pans there. And then as we move over a little bit further, take a look at that. Huge storage there, plenty of room for all your cleaning supplies and a trash can. More storage yet over here. And then you also have 2 drawers, which are perfect for your silverware. Again, full extension ball bearing drawers, nice and large, big enough for all of your larger utensils as well, like your serving spoons and spatulas. And then because this is a front kitchen, you can see great countertop space. You have a ton of prep space here. It's absolutely gorgeous. I showed you this when we were out front. This is your front window there, which is cool because your sink is right here. So as you're doing dishes, you can look out the sink front window. Same thing as you're preparing food, just gives you a beautiful view. But speaking of the sink, you can see I'll take off the sink top cover here. This is a double bowl sink, larger on the left, smaller on the right, high rise faucet there as well. Now the sink top cover not only gives you extra prep space, but it does double as a cutting board. So you can flip it over, use it as a cutting board, and then because this side will have all the knife marks, just flip it right back over, and then the top will make sure it has the nice, beautiful look. As far as electrical outlets, if you take a look right down there, you do have an electrical outlet. So if you do need to plug in a coffee maker, toaster, anything like that, you can easily do so. And then also you'll have an additional one right over here. So great space in here for outlets. Again, so blenders, whatever else you want to put in here, you can definitely do that. Then if we move up top, can take a look at the top storage. You got a good pantry space right up there. The decorative glass on here, I think it gives it a really cool look. And also, I like the fact that they put hinges on there. Struts rather. That way they stay open for one hand operations. A lot of times you're cooking, you know, maybe you have a hand that's covered in raw chicken or something and you don't want to put it up there. And so, you know, when you're cooking, prepping food, it's great to only have to use one hand. So I like that they did that. Great additional storage. LED lights here, of course, as well. So during the day, obviously you have a lot of windows letting in light. At night, you have the LED lights. Those are fantastic. They use a fraction of the power and they don't put out the heat. So you'll definitely appreciate those. Then moving over a little bit further, not only do you have all that pantry space up top, but take a look at this. Great pantry space right there too. You know, that's the beauty of a front kitchen. You just have a lot of room up there. Then as we move back, after you're done preparing a meal, you're gonna want a place to eat it. And that's exactly what you have right here. Freestanding table and chairs. You have 4 chairs here going all the way around. The chairs also do have storage right there. So, you know, that's a great place for maybe paper plates or place settings, something like that. You can stick right down in those chairs, but any extra storage is great storage. And you definitely have plenty of room. It's very easy to get in and out of the chairs. Big windows all the way around too, which is very nice. Again, letting in a lot of natural light. Then right over here is a sofa. This is another great seat to watch a TV or sit and hang out, have a conversation. The other cool thing about this sofa, this is a tri-fold sofa. If you're not familiar with it, this is the most comfortable type of bed you can get in a RV sofa. It uses the actual cushions from the couch itself. Rather than having a bed that's about this thin where you feel a bar in your back or have to wake up, worried about waking up on a deflated air mattress, this is definitely the way to go. Comfortable to sit on, comfortable to sleep on. And then of course, right up here is the TV and entertainment center. 32-inch TV right here. This is on a swing arm mount. So if you need to, you know, pull it out and swing it around to the table and chair, something like that, you can certainly do so. Or, you know, over to the couch or to just leave it right where it is. Then underneath you have the sound bar for superior sound quality and then excellent storage all the way around. We'll start up top. You can see again, the nice decorative glass. So some good storage up there. Then right over here, same thing, great storage there, perfect spot for DVD collection. And then you have nice tall storage here, the cutout there, and additional storage down below. So they did a great job here giving you a lot of storage around that entertainment center. Now walk back with me a little bit into the hall. So this is really cool. If you take a look, this is a huge window. Lets in a ton of natural light during the day. For video quality, I have to have the shades down or it essentially washes everything out. But very large window. It, like I said, really lets a lot of light into the coach. Control panels right here. Everything from your awnings to the lights, slide outs, that tank monitoring system, that will all be right here. And then you have a spot for the remote right there. That's for the rapid camp system I mentioned earlier. Now you do have a door going directly into the bedroom, but before we do that, let's head on into the bathroom. So if you follow me in here real quick, you can see you have plenty of space in this bathroom. Right down here is your foot flush lever toilet. You can take a look. You'll see you have plenty of leg room all the way around, which is very nice. Then right in front of me here is your vanity and sink top. You can see you have good room up here as well for hair dryer, whatever else you need to put, electrical outlet. Storage right there underneath for some items. And then up top here is the mirrored medicine cabinet with additional storage there. The shower in here is very cool. You can see it is a neo-angle shower. I like the door system because it's in a roller track, so that way all the water does stay in the shower pan, doesn't get all over your floor. You have some shelf space there, hand wand, and then a nice big skylight up top. As I step in, you can see not only does this let in a lot of natural light, but I'm 6 foot and I have plenty of headroom up above. Then last but not least, let me shut this door here for you. And you can notice right back here, you have a big linen closet. So for all your towels, all your other bathroom goodies, you have plenty of space to go ahead and put those. All right, folks, let's head on into the bedroom. In the bedroom of the 29FK, you get a slide out queen size bed. It is a full 60 by 80 residential size bed, which is great, especially if you're a taller person. Then if we lift this up, you'll see it is strut supported, so very easy to access. And this was the same area I showed you outside, so you do have dual access points from both outside and right here underneath the bed. Then up front, you have a couple of shelves there. You know, I have had some people that were a little worried that they might sit up and hit the shelf, but I'm telling you, unless you sit up 100% straight, it's not an issue. I've tested it before, not a problem getting up in here, and it does give you a spot to put your cell phones or a glass of water at night. And then also up here, you'll notice additional storage there, the nice decorative glass, LED light there for reading as well. Right over here, you also have a stand, so this is great. It's the electrical outlet there. This is a perfect spot to charge cell phones too, or if you have a CPAP machine, this is large enough where you can fit a lot of the units on that shelf. Then take a look at the foot of the bed. You have a large window here and then this big rear picture window. So between the two of them, lets in a ton of natural light into this space. TV hookups right up top there if you want TV. You have a set of drawers here, nice dresser, full extension drawers. They're very usable as you can see there. Great space. And then right here you have a mirrored wardrobe with additional hanging space and then a drawer right here underneath. Big full extension drawer there. Also, as I did mention, we were outside. You have a vent here, but that one is prepped for a second AC. So if you did want a second AC in this unit, you can certainly have that installed as well. All right, folks, that's pretty much going to wrap it up. Again, this is a 2017 Sprinter Campfire Edition 29FK. This is a really great floor plan, huge front kitchen with a lot of storage there. You know, you have the tri-fold sofa, which is very comfortable not only to sit on but sleep on, good size entertainment center. You can get to the bathroom from the main living area or from the bedroom. Slide out bed gives you full walk around bed and a ton of space in here as well. If you do have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave that in the section below, or you can also give myself, Ian Baker, a call here at American RV and I'll be happy to answer that way as well. If you do have any particular questions on the specs of this unit, or if you're looking for latest price and availability, I recommend you visit our website, which is AmericanRV.com. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to subscribe, that way you can continue to see future content. Thanks again for watching, I'm Ian Baker, and I can't wait to see you on the road to freedom.